Best. Dowling. Hunter wasn't sure, a bit of pushing and shoving. Kidd! Good, quick first-time ball by Best to Gowling. Had Hunter in some trouble. Giles to Clark. Sadler in the middle, looking for Jones, at a present mark by Dunn. Here's Lorimer, setting his sights. And again, that was Stepney's leg. Just flying behind John Giles. Charlton up on the near post, Gowling in front of him this time. Jones off the line by Dunn. No whistle has gone. Tony Dunn who made the clearance. Morgan, Best, Dunn to the right, Clark has come back with him. Good reverse of direction if Burns can keep it, but he can't. Ironic cheers from Leeds supporters. Often this left flank is the start of a Leeds United attack. Lorimer, Cooper is still there, Clark is the other way. Jones coming up. Great work by Tony Dunn, then saved his goalkeeper. What a goal kick has been given. But even so, the presence of Tony Dunn was what saved the goal then. Managed to get back to thwart Jones. Giles. Ran around there quite beautifully. Clark. Jones on the edge of the six-yard box. Gray! Yes, I think it went in. It certainly did that time for Mick Jones, but I think that it may well have gone over the line first from Gray. Billy Bremner with Gray. Alan Clark, who did all the work after he'd been fouled out on the left, working it for Eddie Gray. His shot hitting the post as Stepney got a hand to it. And I think the ball had already gone in before Mick Jones came up and made absolutely sure. Everything's coming off for Leeds. Lorimer on this side, completely unmarked. Clark is up. Jones! And Clark, I think, got the final flick. To Leeds United, and that move started by the tremendous crossfield ball which found Peter Lorimer. The cross eluded Jack Charlton, Mick Jones came in, Alan Clark got a flick to it as it came by, and Leeds two up. And Bremner about 3¼ yards in the end. Bobby Charlton. Well, the ball was never 10 yards or anything like it. Best, Charlton, Burns, yes! Francis Burns, his first goal since November the 22nd, 1969, and look what effect it has had on the Manchester United supporters. Three goals in 8 minutes at the start of the second half. The ball going all over the place, and really in a sense justice done, because the ball was never 10 yards. It finally reached Burns, who poked it in. Well, we got it. Cooper. That's awkward. Bremner. Cross Jones, 3-1. Billy Bremner working it on the right. No doubt that Mick Jones got that one. Totally unmarked on the edge of the six-yard box. All he had to do was nod it down, and he did it to perfection. Garling calling for it in the middle, so is Kidd. Here's Burns, Best, Kidd, desperately close to being offside. All along the crossbar, as it were, and staying in, testing a goalkeeper. Here's Gray, took it off Charlton to say he wasn't there. Here's Lorimer. Jones! A world most definitely looked like that. Eddie Gray started that 1-2. A lovely run in. Took it away from Bobby Charlton, showed it to him, took it away. Lorimer's pushed it in, and Mick Jones touched it home for a matter of about 4 yards. Another great crossfield ball to Eddie Gray, who's having his best match since the cup final against Chelsea at Wembley. Free kick against Alan Clark. Talking to Les Cocker, the trainer. The linesman also talking to Alan Clark. And the boo's going on because I think the name of Alan Clark is going into the book. No doubt that he fouled first time, but Mr. Burtonshaw taking a strong line on it. And that's Alan Clark's third booking, and that's why he's so unhappy about it. And also the name of O'Neill going into the book for the retaliation. And Mr. Burtonshaw obviously felt that he had to take the name of O'Neill. And Clark read that. He's in on his own. Well, he tried almost too hard. The courage of the player and the sureness of his touch, and he was prepared to go on until it was absolutely right. But in the end, it was wrong. And Samu McElroy coming on while the injured Clark gets attention. The man who's got off is Brian Kidd on the field, and Peter Lorimer to take the corner. Jack Charlton. Lorimer. That was a rather of a hidden hope. Bremner, yes, it stayed in. The whole of the ball's got across the line. Jones. Lorimer. Five. That's the reaction of the Leeds crowd. Peter Lorimer is the scorer, smiles all over his face. The move started by Billy Bremner, down to Jones, who hit the cross having found space for himself. Lorimer looked to have lost it, but he wasn't going to give up. And how typical of the Leeds United play this afternoon. Giles. Lorimer. Stepney stretching all the way. Magnificent second half performance by Leeds United. I must have some sympathy for Manchester United, but they must know that they were beaten this afternoon by a great team who really turned it on for one of the most exhilarating performances of the season in that second half. There's the captain of Leeds United, who a few weeks ago were compared with Real Madrid. Well, they came closer to it this afternoon than ever. 4 goals in 9 minutes, 6 goals in 25, in the best second half that you could hope to see anywhere. It was great stuff, and Leeds United were brilliant.